brings you out here today?
I'll support my fellow Patriots, you know, try to bring some awareness to the rest of the country that we need to open back up. And our governor and our mayor needs to understand that as well.
My heart goes out to the people who have lost family members and friends to this virus. I mean, it's a scary thing, but what's much scarier is locking everyone down and taking away our freedoms and our rights to earn, our rights to provide. So many more people will be hurt, depressed, dying inside and dying, you know, physically dying because they can't work.
In a matter of a few weeks, everyone is being affected in such a way that you got people in bread lines. You got people standing in food drive trying to get some food to feed their family. You got Nancy Pelosi talking about her favorite ice creams, and people can't even put food on the table for their family.
Hey guys, it's like this. This week we are in downtown Los Angeles, masked up at the Open California protest. These California patriots are mad that the government has overreached and locked everyone inside. They think it's an overreaction to the COVID-19 virus, and they're here to say something about it. We here at Fleckus Talks have our second sponsor ever. We are sponsored by the Trump 2020 MAGA masks. Check these out. Do you guys like these masks? We're going to need masks going forward. Unfortunately, I hate it. I hate wearing them. But if you're going to wear one, you might as well wear one. That's cool. The link is in the bio. Get yours today. They are great.
I'm not impressed with Nancy and her freezer full of gourmet ice cream.
And vodka.
Oh, well, I didn't know about that.
Yeah, she loves to drink. And yeah, her nephew, Gavin Newsom, they're just really doing a number on California.
Well, governments are to represent the people, not be their masters.
The people need to be involved. We must be involved in the process. The whole decision-making process, you know, blindly mandating, it's like you don't have that power. This is our country. We pay your bills. We pay your salary. We pay for your equipment. We pay for the microphone that you're telling us we need to stay inside for. So, you know, it's our choice.
I never understood that a governor and a mayor can team up in such a way to deem what is essential and what is not essential.
You can't go to a church. A church is not essential. You can go buy pot. Nothing against anyone who smokes weed. But the point is, how is marijuana and getting high essential and not going to have some faith in something or go pray? How?
Yeah, sucking a baby out of your stomach.
How do you justify that?
As you guys know, this is more important than ever. I feel like this COVID event has kind of opened a can of worms. I mean, there are so many different things we can talk about. Government corruption, overreach, a lack of representation for the people. It's pretty scary. I feel like we're getting towards a point where we almost got to call a pause and say, hey, look, this is our country.
The world keeps spinning. You know, there's nothing that stops. Not going to stop just because this virus popped along. Your bills are still going to accumulate. You're still going to have things you got to deal with. But the government put no pause on it. The only thing you put a pause on is where you can go, who you can go with, how far you can be from them, when you can be there, where to stand, how to talk, how to dress, how to act, when to come out. That's not America.
What brings you out here today?
I'm a single mom, business owner. Opened a gourmet food truck 7 years ago. Was doing phenomenally well in West Los Angeles, greater Los Angeles area. And literally 3 days after this lockdown came down, all the clients canceled. Everyone went home to work, and all of my clients are locked down, and we're shut. We had to literally shut my truck down yesterday after 7 years.
I lost three of my jobs. It's like my parents, they brought me on a really big upbringing of, you know, work for what you want to get. And, you know, the government, you know, Gavin Newsom, they just took that from me, like my will to work. And when I applied for that EDD, like, it broke my heart.
What do you do for work?
I'm a carpenter and a set dresser in the film industry.
So what's it been like? Everything's been shut down?
Oh, everything's been shut down, man. I had three good jobs lined up right before they started shutting everything down, and all of them got tanked.
What do you do for work?
I'm an interior designer, and I'm actually out of work. So right now, I do nothing.
And did you get that $1,200 mini check?
I did not, because I'm self-employed.
I haven't been able to work since March 8th. I work at Santa Anita Racetrack, take bets on horses. And I got the $1,200, big deal, you know?
You can't lock down people forever. And you tell us originally, remember, changing goalposts. Originally, he goes and he says 14 days. That's the reason we need 14 days, the hospitals need to catch up. He said that. He said if it doesn't happen, it's going to be this curve. Without mitigation, with mitigation, and with the mitigation that he prescribed, it kept getting revised. It's not even hitting 2,000 hospital beds of 26,000 that were designated for COVID-19. Obviously, we want to take care of the elderly and those who are most vulnerable, but you don't need a lockdown the 80% who are either not going to get it or going to get mild symptoms.
There's people with COVID all the time in the hospital. They're getting discharged, you know what I mean? And, you know, and they're scaring people where, you know, people can't even shake hands anymore. They're separating people. And diseases kill everybody. I mean, they kill people regardless of COVID or, you know, anything else, H1N1, a bunch of stuff. And we need to open up and work.
Hey, listen, people are, they're tired. They're fed up. They want to get back to work. This 0.0005 of a 1% death rate compared to the population of 40 million, it doesn't justify it. So while you're preaching this whole science and let's, dude, shut up, dude. People are f***ing over. They're not buying it. These people aren't drinking the Kool-Aid.
Are you seeing any of the coronavirus, COVID-19 action firsthand in the hospitals?
Yes, of course. It's a virus. It kills just like any other thing, you know, but they're hyping us up to where somebody goes there with a respiratory issue and he dies, then they're saying COVID-19 when they didn't even test it. Like, I'm in the front lines. If you want to talk about somebody being there, I'm there. I'm in emergency rooms.
So what exactly are they doing? I've heard of that too. Basically, if someone dies and they had COVID, they're saying they died from COVID, right?
Well, the thing is this. I know you guys do know that that the federal government's paying for COVID patients. So anybody that's intubated is actually getting the hospital's game, from what I understand, over $30,000. And other people that are just positive, you know, they get $13,000. So the hospitals are, their ERs are empty. They're basically empty, you know, and they want those COVIDs, you know. And they're using this for propaganda to scare people, and everybody's scared, and the numbers are not there. I've been doing this for a long time, and there's a lot of diseases. People die all the time, but they're using this to scare people.
This doesn't help anyone to be this scared of something that I, have you ever met someone who has it? No, neither have I. I've never actually met anyone with this virus. So for me, it's like, this is crap. So
actually, Tony Beans from Patreon, we know a guy from Patreon who has it, but that's just one guy.
That's one guy.
And he was fine.
Yeah. That's another thing. It's like you get people who have this and then they don't have these horrible symptoms. They're not dying, but we're supposed to like freak out and think this is like the Black Plague.
Everything's been flipped. You know, we're kind of living in an inverted society and people got to wake up. I'm a little worried because I think we're getting to the point of, I hate to say it, but like a civil war.
Can I have your attention, please? Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention? My name is Captain Rick Stabile from the Los Angeles Police Department. If you are standing in the roadway, that is illegal, and I need you to get up on the sidewalk.
It's not about you versus me. It's about, wait a second, how can we help each other? How about that one?
I'd say we're on the same team, but the 1% of the 1% of the 1% want us against each other. So it's black versus white, man versus woman, immigrant versus whoever. And in reality, it's us versus them, but they don't want us to realize it.
Any person or group that you see that is promoting disagreement between people, that's the enemy.
You know, it's funny because I rock the MAGA. I rock the MAGA hat, and I go out there and I see people, you know, always on the drive-by, of course, you know, vilifying me because I wear the hat. I sport the flag. I wave this flag proudly. I get vilified for that, too. I never understood that flying a flag of our country that gives us these rights, I never knew that was a bad thing until you come to California. You come to California, all of a sudden it's a huge issue. You can't be a patriot in California.
I love Donald Trump, dude. And you know what? If you're a Democrat or a tranny or whatever, you know what? I love you too. Honestly, I really don't care, man. You know what I'm saying? They try to creep their they try to creep their evil shit into the politics, so it makes it about black and white. So it makes it about left versus right. So it makes it about gay versus non-gay or whatever. You know? It's not about that, dude. So again, anything you see that's promoting a violence or a discord or disharmony, that's the bad guys.
We have Fauci and Bill Gates doing all the super shady stuff out in the open, mainstream completely ignoring it, telling us to be scared of the virus instead.
Yeah, you get you a vaccine soon. Marina Abramovich doing a Microsoft ad.
They want to enforce vaccines on all of us. Come on.
It's a wrap. Fauci, you're a liar. Everything you guys are talking about, you're manipulating statistics, you're overcounting the bodies to try and get money inside of your hospitals to feed your deficit so you can make it look like you know what you're doing and running your state, but you don't know what you're doing. I'm in Southern California, I'm in the hornet's nest. Yeah. We're not all lost out here.
I mean, everyone has shown up. The truckers have shown up.
The truckers are here. Cass, check out the truckers.
They're blasting their horns like, it literally sounded like dinosaurs coming down the street. It's a great turnout. No one here has caused any issues. There hasn't been any problems. There's no littering. There's no... Antifa showed up.
They started problems. Dude, the law enforcement was on our side. They separated them. They contained them. They moved them away. All good.
Good day. Great event.
Hold on. That sounds like the Trump is worse than Hitler go.
It does.
Donald Trump is worse than Hitler!
They're also seeming like they're going to start pushing for mail-in voting. That's the big scheme. I think they're going to get out of it.
Mail-in voting is just another way for the Democrats to try and harvest dead people or illegals or other people where you can't check it, where you can just go the night of and drop an envelope inside of a mailbox, and then it counts as a vote. That's the most ridiculous thing in the world.
Take control of your lives. You got to get up off your butt. A lot of people don't want to do that. They're scared, but a time is coming, and people like me we're going to have to step up, man. But once again, I appreciate what you do. Keep it up. Stay strong. I know it's not easy, and thank you.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Appreciate it. Thanks for talking to me. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, all the good stuff. Special thanks to our sponsor for this episode, the Trump 2020 masks. Get yours. The links are in the bio. Make sure you guys get yours. We're going to have to be wearing these masks for a while. You might as well get a cool one. ShopFleckus.com for the cool shirts, cool merch, and Patreon.com/Fleckus for Fleckus Talks the Show with me and Croxon. Thank you, guys. We'll see you at the next one.
Cool. That works.
Thanks for talking to me. That was great.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it.
I'm going to get that shirt.
Hell yeah. Thank you.
Absolutely. Hey, just hold that back.
Saturday, 12 o'clock, we're going to be at Mayor Garcetti's home. Show up, tell all your friends, we're taking it up a notch.
Hell yeah.
We're not done until California.